And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect. Blind, I want to go see about training. I think we talked to the requisitions officer about that.
In other news, Exogeni Corp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
Okay, well that's this. Awkward silence in the elevator. Hey, who farted? Rex? Requisition office. This way.
Hello, Commander.
No supplies?
Show me what you got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Well, this must be a mistake.
Huh.
System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre. Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
No problem.
Just show me what you got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
Yeah, a whole bunch of crap we can't afford. Wish we have 3615. Solaris amp. What's a biotic? Biotic amplifier? Can I get this medium armor? Hydra 2. Now I don't have that, right? Let me just check. Oh, I do have medium armor. I have Phoenix one. Oh, wait. I can't use it. I'm supposed to be able to use medium armor, aren't I? Maybe I have to level that up first? Tactical armor. Unlock tactical armor. Oh, okay. First I have to unlock this, and then I have to get all the way here just to be able to use medium armor. Alright, so we're not getting any medium armor yet then. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go without the Spectre stuff for now. Wonder where those other guys are. Well, this goes to the wards. I'm not going up there. I swear they said I have to report to someone for Spectre training.
trouble, Commander.
Not now. Not now.
Not now. Not now. And where's this go? Traffic control. I doubt anyone up here, but let me just look. Maybe they meant report to him for weapons and armor. All right, let's get out of here. The Normandy is our ship now. It's pretty awesome. Pretty exciting.
Chairman Burns of the Parliament Subcommittee on Transhuman Studies has been kidnapped by biotic extremists. The biotics commandeered a freighter and were last seen in the Hades Gamma Cluster. No demands have yet been made.
So every time we hear one of these news reports, we get another thing. Find the freighter in the Farinata system of the Hades Gamma Cluster and make your way to the biotics on board. I'm gonna not want to take elevators anymore. We're gathering quests up again. These doors are so quiet when they come down. Cool.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Decontamination in progress.
What would happen to Captain Anderson? Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics.
That sucks.
Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
I don't know, this feels wrong.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it, nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander, 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
I need to be honest with them.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
Earth Prime was just a start.
This began with an attack on a human settlement in the Traverse.
But we know Saren won't stop there. His Geth armies aren't going to stay on the far fringes of Citadel space.
We must not fail.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
Oh my god, he doesn't matter anymore. I won't let him down.
The captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, ma'am.
I can look outside. Oh. Ships and vehicles. Huh. Huh. New space travelers ask, what does it look like outside a ship moving at faster than light speed? Part of the answer can be seen in a simple pane of glass. Light travels slower through glass than it does through open air. Light also moves slower in conventional space than it does in a high-speed mass effect field. This causes refraction. Any light entering at an angle is bent and separated into a spectrum. Objects outside the ship will appear refracted. The greater the difference between the objective, exterior, and subjective, interior speeds of light, the greater the refraction. As the subjective speed of light is raised within the field, objects outside will appear to redshift, eventually becoming visible only to radio telescope antennae. High-energy electromagnetic sources normally hidden to the eye become visible in the high blue spectrum. As the speed of light continues to be raised, X-ray, gamma-ray, and eventually cosmic ray sources become visible. Stars will be replaced by pulsars, the accretion disks of black holes, quasars, and gamma-ray bursts. To an outside observer, a ship within a mass effect drive envelope appears blue-shifted. If within a field that allows travel at twice the speed of light, any radiation it emits has twice the energy as normal. If the ship is in a field of about 200 times light speed, it radiates visible light as X-rays and gamma rays, and the infrared heat from the hull is blue-shifted up into the visible spectrum or higher. Ships moving at faster than light are visible at great distances, though their signature will only propagate at the speed of light. That's awesome. I love stuff like that.
Commander, something you need?
Status report.
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet, if you've got a pilot who knows how to handle her. Balance isn't what you'd expect. Takes a while to get used to that oversized drive core we got stuffed in the back, and her power can sneak up on you if you're not careful. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot, Commander. Lucky for you, I'm anything but average.
Yeah. I don't think your ego is very average, though. Just want to talk.
I'd like to know my crew. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
I can see where this is going. You did a background check on me, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you the same thing I told the captain.
Don't we already know?
You want me as your pilot. I'm not good. I'm not even great. I am the best damn helmsman in the Alliance fleet.
Looks like he's biting his lip.
Top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those commendations in my file, I earned every single one. Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease.
Stop biting your lip when you talk. What disease?
What are you talking about? Are you sick?
You mean you didn't know? Oh, crap. Okay, I've got Froelich syndrome, brittle bone disease. The bones in my legs never develop properly. They're basically hollow, too much force, and they'll shatter. Even with crutches and my leg braces, it's hard to get around. One wrong step and crack! It's very dramatic. But I've learned to manage my condition, Commander. Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you. Just don't ask me to get up and dance unless, you know, you like the sound of snapping shin bones.
That's horrible. How'd you get your nickname?
Why does everyone call you Joker?
It's a lot shorter than saying Alliance Flight Lieutenant Jeff Moreau.
Jeff
Plus,
Moreau.
Plus, I love to make little children laugh.
That's no answer.
You're dodging the question.
Look, I didn't pick the name. One of the instructors in flight school used to bug me about never smiling. She started calling me Joker, and it stuck.
Were you unhappy?
Why didn't you ever smile?
Hey, I worked my ass off in flight school, Commander. The world's not gonna hand you anything if you go around grinning like an idiot. By the end of the year, I was the best pilot in the academy. Even better than the instructors, and everybody knew it. They'd all got their asses kicked by the sickly kid with the creaky little legs. One guess who was smiling at graduation?
Tell me about your disease.
I need to know more about this Froelich syndrome if I'm putting my ship in your hands.
Yeah, of course you do. It's an extremely rare condition. Nobody knows exactly what causes it. Genetic, maybe. It's treatable, but there's no cure. They classify my case as moderate to severe. I was born with over a dozen fractures. Hip, thighs, ankles. My bones were already breaking in the womb. 100 years ago, I wouldn't have survived past my first year. Lucky for me, modern medical science has turned me into a productive member of society.
You know, he reminds me of the villain, quote-unquote, from the movie Unbreakable. How do you do your job?
You're not gonna break a bone trying to fly the ship, are you?
I don't fly with my feet, Commander, so I'm fine as long as I'm in this chair. I gotta be real careful when I get up to take a piss, though. I can do my job as well as anyone on the ship. Better, actually. So don't worry about it.
So wait, it's only in his legs, not in his arms or fingers? What if you press a button too hard?
I'm not trying to make you uncomfortable. Let's talk about something else.
Whatever you want, Commander.
Tell me more about your personal history.
How'd you end up joining the Alliance?
Look, if you're looking for an inspirational tale of the crippled kid overcoming impossible odds, you're gonna be disappointed. My mother was a civilian contractor working for the Alliance. I basically grew up on the Arcturus station back when they were building up the fleets. Spend all that time around Alliance ships, there's a good chance you'll end up going to the Academy.
Hmm. Okay, well that's all then.
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Alright, see ya. Planets and locations. Arcturus Station. Arcturus Station is the gateway to Sol, a 5 kilometer diameter standard Stanford Taurus type space station at the trailing Lagrange point of the gas giant Themis. Pardon me guys, it's getting a little thick here. Construction on Arcturus Station began in 2151 and concluded in 2162. It was inaugurated in 2156 and has served as the military and political headquarters of the Systems Alliance from the First Contact War until the present. When humanity activated the Charon Mass Relay in 2149, it led to Arcturus, 36 light-years from Sol, Earth's sun. Arcturus is the third brightest star seen from Earth. It is an ancient red giant from the generation born before Sol. Its worlds are either gas giants or ice chunks. While some rocky debris exists, the metal content is 25% lower than normal. To build Arcturus Station, metallic asteroids were towed through the mass relays to the construction site. That's pretty cool. I'm like picturing that. Many of the asteroids remain near the station, their mined-out areas home to transient populations. The expense of bringing construction materials into the system was acceptable due to its strategic value. With 3 primary mass relays in addition to the secondary one to Sol, Arcturus is a major communications and military choke point. The Alliance First Fleet is based in Arcturus, where it can guard the gates to Sol and react to incursions in the 3 connected clusters. The station also holds the System Alliance Parliament and the Systems Alliance Military General Headquarters. Its permanent population is approximately 45,000. Arcturus is actually from the galactic halo, one of a cluster of 52 stars that are crashing through the disk of the galaxy. In a billion years, Arcturus will be sailing through the depths of extragalactic dark space. Damn. That's fascinating. Anyway, we have to walk around and talk to more people and learn about their history and stuff. Navigator Presley. What's going on here? I can't really talk to him. I don't know what's going on there. It says I can talk, but I can't talk. Okay. Oh, I just got Codex and level up. I'm torn between working towards tactical armor, medium armor, and getting throw and lift. Advanced throw. Advanced warp. We'll do that. I have 4 left. Yeah, I should level this up. Okay.
The Citadel is an ancient deep space station.
Citadel space.
Citadel space is an unofficial term referring to any region of space controlled by a species that acknowledges the authority of the Citadel Council. At first glance, it appears this territory encompasses most of the galaxy. In reality, however, less than 1% of the stars have been explored. Even Mass Effect FTL Drive is slow relative to the volume of the galaxy. Empty space and systems without suitable drive discharge sites are barriers to exploration. Only the mass relays allow ships to jump hundreds of light years in an instant, the key to expanding across an otherwise impassable galaxy. Whenever a new relay is activated, the destination system is rapidly developed. From that hub, FTL Drive is used to expand to nearby star clusters. The result is a number of densely developed clusters, thinly spread across the vast expanse of space, connected by the mass relay network.
Cool. I wonder how often we come across new relays. I wonder if we'll come across a new relay. No spoilers, please. Just wondering.
The Normandy is a prototype starship developed by the Human Systems Alliance with the assistance of the Citadel Council. It is optimized for scouting and reconnaissance missions in unstable regions, using state-of-the-art stealth technology. For most ships, the heat generated through standard operations is easily detectable against the absolute zero background of space. The Normandy, however, is able to temporarily sink this heat within the hull. Combined with refrigeration of the exterior hull, the ship can travel undetected for hours, or drift passively for days of covert observation. This is not without risk. The stored heat must eventually be radiated, or it will build to levels capable of cooking the crew alive.
Damn.
Another component of the stealth system is the Normandy's revolutionary Tantalus drive, a Mass Effect core twice the standard size. The Tantalus drive generates mass concentrations that the Normandy falls into, allowing it to move without the use of heat-emitting thrusters.
Nice. Citadel. Supposedly constructed by the long-extinct Protheans, this colossal deep space station serves as the capital of the Citadel vessel. Gravity is simulated through its rotation and is a comfortable 1.02 standard Gs on the wards and a light 0.3 standard Gs on the Presidium ring. That's a lot of freaking metric tons. Oh, cool. Awesome. What's this widow that shows up? Oh, the widow cluster? That's where we are, right? Or the widow nebula? Serpent nebula? Wow. Okay, there's Novaria. Argos Row. Exodus Cluster. Hawking Eta. Kepler Verge. Oh, these are all the different mass relays, so we have to link to different ones. Got it. Gemini Sigma. So that's the Yara's dig site. Hades Gamma. Have a mission there. Voyager Cluster. Attic and Beta. I think we have two missions in Hades Gamma. Armstrong Nebula. Well, everything's this way. Okay, I'm gonna see who else I can talk to first before we start going places. talk to him. Believe me, I'm eager to... to go. Nothing here, right? Yeah, I remember walking in here. Shepherd's locker. Oh, I got stuff. Tickle all. I can give it to a party member. Sniper rifle, maybe. Systems Alliance N7. The Alliance Military Vocational Code System classifies the career path of all serving personnel. An MVC consists of one letter and one number. A soldier's MVC includes proficiency, not rank. The letter notes career path. The number indicates level of experience, as indicated by service record, technical scores, and commendations. All 26 letters are used, and numbers run from 1 to 7. N is the letter code for Special Forces personnel. Huh. I always assumed N was for Normandy. Oh, yes, Caden. Say a word.
Anything you need, Commander?
Tactical appraisal?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
She's shiny.
I don't see how we could have done things any better. At least not without getting to Eden Prime sooner. And we were on the scene faster than any other Alliance ship could have been.
I'm also looking for personal input.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
Jeez, I asked you a question. Alright, bye.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Yeah, that's light. I gotta put some powder on my face. Sleeper pod. Where's our narrator? Cabins give each individual 10 cubic meters of space. On larger vessels, private rooms are common. As ships get smaller, the number of crew packed into a single wardroom increases. Asari prefers shaped spaces even on large vessels, while Krogan territorial instincts make it impossible for them to cohabitate even on the smallest ships. On smaller vessels, hot bunking is the norm. Crew members assigned to different watches share the same bunk. When one gets off duty, he wakes up the person in the bunk. When that crewman is on duty, the first gets his rack time. Spacecraft compartments can be isolated by airtight doors in case of decompression. The cinematic vision of explosive decompression is fiction. Hold compartments either take enough damage that occupants are killed instantly or leak slowly enough that they are able to reach protective gear. Compartments are equipped with emergency life support apparatus, fireproof plastic bubbles with air bottles. Small when stowed, ELSA, emergency life support apparatus, comfortably accommodate one individual inflated. Damage control procedure cuts off ventilation to burning compartments. Without oxygen to consume, fires die in seconds. The compartment is repressurized afterwards for crew recovery. Mass effect fields create an artificial gravity agrav plane below the decks, preventing muscle atrophy and bone loss in zero G. Large vessels arrange their decks perpendicular to their thrust axis. The highest decks are at the bow and the lowest at the engines. This allows agrav to work with the inertial effects of thrust. Ships that can land arrange their decks laterally so the crew can move about while the vessel is on the ground. Warships normally turn off their agrav systems during combat, reducing the heat generated by systems and increasing combat endurance. To provide a point of reference for navigating in zero G, floors are painted a different color from the walls and ceiling. Okay. Deck 3. Oh, I missed stuff though. So. Okay. Medical. I think I used some metagel, didn't I? Cool. Let's go in here first. Well, there wasn't anything here last time.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
We can ask for something about Kaden?
How well do you know the Lieutenant?
I'd never worked with him before this mission. But he has an impressive service record. Over a dozen special commendations. Tends to keep to himself, though. Maybe because of the headaches. It's not easy being an L2.
An L2? We might have been through this dialogue before.
What does that have to do with it?
Well, most biotics now use the L3 implants. Lieutenant Alenka was wired with the old L2 configuration. Sometimes there are complications.
What kind of complications?
Severe mental disabilities, insanity, crippling physical pain. There's a long list of horrific side effects. Caden's lucky. He just gets migraines.
How did you end up serving on an Alliance ship?
I enlisted right out of med school. Earth always seemed boring to me. Too safe, too secure. I figured the colonies were teeming with exotic adventure.
Yeah, I've been
I
all
wanted
that.
To travel the stars, tending the wounds of tough soldiers with piercing eyes and sensitive souls. Turns out military life isn't quite as romantic as I'd imagined. But humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse. And the Alliance always needs good doctors. So I stayed on to do my part.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Yeah, we've been through all that. So I guess these are my quarters. Personnel manual. Military ranks. The Alliance uses a modified version of the ranking system that has been used for hundreds of years. Soldiers are classified into rank and file enlisted personnel, experienced non-commissioned officers, NCOs, and specially trained officers. The divide between naval personnel and ground forces, Marines, is small. Ground units are a specialized branch of the fleet, just as fighter squadrons are. This unity of command is imposed by the futility of fighting without control of orbit. Without the Navy, any army is pointless. The Marines, as a matter of pride, maintain some of their traditional rank titles. For example, Marines have privates and corporals instead of servicemen. In ascending order of responsibility, the ranks of the Alliance are enlisted. Servicemen 3rd class, privates 2nd class. Yeah, like I say, you guys can look at this. So enlisted, NCOs, science gunnery operations, officers. That's what I get out of my little manual. Yeah, I've been here. Oop.